Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss an update from Shemaroo Kids. Shemaroo Kids.
What are you doing? I'm flying my spaceship. Hey, won't it be great if we all could fly in a spaceship?
Yes, it will be really fun.
But who will take us in the spaceship?
Here, take this. You can fly in my spaceship.
Your spaceship is so small that my finger will also not go into it.
Let's call Vayu and Maya.
Yes, let's call them.
Vayu, Maya, please come.
We need your help.
Vayu.
Please come.
We need your help.
Hello, children.
Hello, kids.
Hello, Vayu.
Hello, Maya.
So, what are you children doing here?
Vayu, we want to travel in a spaceship.
You children are getting very adventurous.
I can take you for a ride in the spaceship. But there is a problem.
What is the problem?
We all will have to become very small, just like ants.
So that we can move anywhere freely and nobody will be able to see us.
That will be really fun.
Okay, so are you ready to get shrunk?
Yes.
Become so big.
The tree has not become big. We have become small.
Come on, children. The spaceship is waiting for us.
there, Bunty. He's so big.
Is he your friend?
No, he's the naughtiest boy in the whole school. Always creates trouble.
That's really bad manners.
But he really enjoys troubling others.
Hey, let's land on him. So tomorrow, when we tell him about it, he will be shocked.
That's a good idea.
Vayu, let's land on Bunty. It will be great fun.
Okay, okay. Let's land on Bunty and take this opportunity to see the parts of our body more closely. In this way, we'll all know more about our body.
Wow, it will be an adventure.
Children, do you know what we call this surface?
Skin.
Very good. This is our skin. The skin holds our body together and in proper shape. It also saves the liquids inside our body from drying.
Wow!
Children, when we go for swimming or take our daily bath, the water doesn't enter our body. This is because our skin is waterproof.
Our skin also produces sweat so that our bodies remain cool while it is hot outside. Now children, what do you think about nails? Our nails are also a form of skin that is hard and strong. The nails protect our fingertips and toes.
Hey, look what Bunty is doing.
Did you all carefully see what Bunty did? He made use of his fingers. Children, we all are lucky to have thumbs as one of our fingers. It was using this thumb along with the other fingers that Bunty was able to pick up the stone. See, we all can touch our thumbs to our fingers. Because of this, we can pick any object and do lots of things.
And where are our fingers attached? To our palms. Look, children, this is our palm. Did you all see, children, how he bent his hand to throw the stone?
Yes!
Look, children, there is a joint in the middle of the arm. We call this joint as elbow. See, children, because of our elbows, we can bend our arms. See, like this. So you see, children, The elbow helps our hand move freely in one direction. And because of this free movement, we can do lots of things with our hands.
This is our legs. The legs carry our body and helps us move from one place to another. Can you see? When Bunty is walking, his legs get bent at the center. Just as we have elbows on our hands, there is also a joint on our legs, and we call this joint as knees. Can you see the knees of Bunty?
Yes!
Look, children, the leg is joined to the feet. Just as our hands has fingers, our feet also has fingers. When we go out, we wear shoes so that we don't hurt our feet. Once again, children, let me remind you, we should take good care of all our body parts so that we remain healthy every day.
Look, the hair is so long.
Children, there are about 3 lakh hairs on the head.
Wow.
Vayu, why do we have so many hairs on our head?
Our hair is like a cap on our head. It protects our head from the sun rays and heat.
Okay.
Vayu, when the barber cuts my hair, I don't feel any pain. But when I pull my hair, it pains. Why is that?
Very good question, Pete. You see, children, only the very bottom part of our each hair is alive. The upper part is dead, and when you cut the dead portion, you don't feel the pain. But when you pull your hair, you are also pulling the alive part of the hair. So it pains. Did you understand?
Hey, shall I pull Bunty's hair?
He will not feel the pain right now because we are very small in size.
Some children have freckles because their skin contains little clumps of special coloring called melanin. This melanin protects the skin from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun.
Okay, now I remember. I saw my daddy's photo when he was a small boy just like me. My daddy had freckles. But now they are gone.
As we grow older, our freckles often go away. But some people have freckles even when they grow old.
Hey, Vayu, Maya, let's see the naughty eyes of Bunty.
Okay, let's go.
Hey, look, his eyes are moving so fast.
That's because he's watching the things around him.
Hey, look! The black thing in his eyes have grown so big.
We call that black thing as the pupil.
But why has the pupil suddenly become so big?
That's because suddenly it has grown cloudy outside. Can you see the clouds covering the sun?
Yes!
Because the surrounding got cloudy outside, the pupil of the eye became bigger to let in more light to make us see the surroundings clearly.
Wow! This is really amazing!
Hey, look children! Now the sun has come out of the cloud and the surrounding has become brighter.
Hey, look! Bunty's pupil has again become smaller.
Yes!
This has happened so that the excess light doesn't enter the pupil. This helps protect the inside of our eyes that is very, very sensitive.
Vayu, I also want to know, why do our eyes keep closing and opening?
The closing and opening of our eyes is called blinking.
So why do we blink?
Children, closely look at the eyes of Bunty. Each eye has got a cover that can move up and down. This cover is called an eyelid. This eyelid of ours uses the wetness in our eyes to wipe out any dirt or small particles that falls on the surface of our eyes. So you see, children, we blink to keep our eyes clean from dirt.
I don't know how many times I blink in the day.
We human beings blink every 6 seconds whole day long.
Wow!
Children, as we are talking about our eyes, let me also tell you how we see the things around us. Children, our two eyes are like two complex sensors. Now as you all look at Bunty, the light bounces off from the face of Bunty and it enters our eye through the pupil. This picture of Bunty is focused on the back of the eye by the lens of our eyes. And the interesting thing is that the picture of Bunty is upside down.
Huh?
Yes. Then what happens is that the back of our eye sends this upside down picture of Bunty to the brain. The brain then looks at the picture and turns this upside down picture of Bunty to right side up again.
Wow! That's really interesting.
If our brain didn't turn the pictures right side up, then we all would be seeing each other upside down.
Children, every part of our body is very important and we should always take good care of our body parts.
Look children, this is what we call the nose. We all breathe fresh air and our body sends out the impure air from the nose.
Maya, we also use nose to smell, don't we?
Yes.
Children, look here. This is how our ears look. See carefully. The outside of the ear is like the shape of a funnel. Whatever sound is created in our surroundings, we hear it with the help of our ears.
But how?
Let me explain it to you. Our ear picks up the sound traveling through the air and sends it through the funnel down a tube to the eardrum. eardrum is a thin sheet of skin stretched tightly like a drum. As the sound reaches the eardrum, it starts to move back and forth in fast motion. We say that the eardrum starts vibrating. Then near the eardrum, there are three tiny bones and a special coil that change the vibrations into signals and send these signals to the brain. Then our brain tells us what noise we are hearing.
Just like the brain tells us what we see.
Yes.
Now look, children, this is what we call mouth. The upper and the lower part is called the lips. We use mouth to speak good things and eat delicious food.
Like Bunty is using his mouth to eat the apple.
Look, children, this is our teeth. Teeth helps us bite our food and break them into small pieces. So, we should always keep our teeth clean by brushing after every meal.
So, children, now you all know the various parts of our body.
Yes!
Thank you, Vayu.
Thank you, Maya.
Children, it is always great fun to tell you all about various things that will make you all intelligent and smart.
Get out, Vayu.
Don't you kids worry. As he opens his mouth, we will zoom out.
Hey, look! He's opening his mouth.
Oh no! He's drinking water. Vayu, quick! Get the spaceship out of the way of the water.
What will happen to the spaceship? Will they be able to come out of Bunty's mouth? If yes, how will they find their way out?
Don't forget to watch the second series as we take you through yet another adventure inside the body of Bunty.
Hi kids! Hope you liked the video!
Subscribe for more fun videos!